Hey guys, Tales of Creed here. Welcome back to some more Let's Play Xenogears. Oh man. Last time we left off, we figured out pretty much all of Phase Pass. We figured out everything about Id, everything about Groth, everything about Faye's father, Faye's mother. Pretty much everything you could possibly know about Faye, we figured it out last time. And this time, we are going to go do some optional stuff as well as go through the final dungeon of the game. Don't know how long this session's gonna last, but probably won't be like as long as usual. So, off screen, I did go ahead and get the money I wanted. I have 500,000 gold. I also went ahead and got, if I go to the equip, I got the speed shoes for everyone. At least I got three of them. I feel like that's all you'll need, really. And the party I'm going to be mainly using for this final dungeon and final battle is this party right here. I want to use this party. And that's about it. So let's get moving. I did check the whole thing I was talking about at where everyone is currently in the game. I was actually wrong. There isn't any more scenes there unless you want to do some other stuff, which I don't really feel like doing. So I'm going to head straight for the lighthouse now. And we'll do the lighthouse. We'll get some really cool stuff there. I'm going to be buying a lot of things there. To be honest, probably won't have any money left after this, actually. Gonna be buying quite a few things. As for where I grinded right up here. This is Anima Relic number 2. If you have the trader card and you just fight enemies out here, you'll get tons and tons of money. Granted, it did take me about I don't want to say 3 hours. It took me around 2 hours to get what I got. So, 500,000 in about 2 hours isn't that bad. I also grinded a little bit, but honestly, whoops, I'm sorry. I wanted to show off my levels, but I forgot I'd have to come back in here. But let's just show it now that I'm in here. As you can see, I grinded a couple levels. I didn't grind that much because, honestly, the final dungeon is all a gear dungeon. Even the final battle is a gear dungeon, or a gear fight. There is no more fighting by yourselves on land, unless you want to do some optional stuff. None of it's required. So, your gear is not dependent on what level you are, honestly. It's all dependent on the gear parts and gear equipment that you have, so I don't see a point in really leveling up at this point in the game. But anyway, here is the lighthouse. We're going to be heading in here. Down here, we're going to be buying quite a few things, as well as getting a optional scene that we really, really should get. The base of this lighthouse was built several thousand years ago. Islanders added a light to make it into a lighthouse, but no one knows what it really is. Alright. Let's head inside. I like how we're just clipping through the elevator right there. It's nice. It's nice. I love it. But yeah, I really can't believe I'm doing this session, honestly. I can't believe I'm about to go through the final dungeon. But one thing I should mention is I'm probably going to... I have a guide open for the final dungeon because it's a little mazy. I don't want to be stuck for a while, so I just decided I'd keep that open. We've come a long way from there. Okay. So welcome to the lighthouse place. This place is pretty significant. I'm going to be going to certain places throughout this place just to show off some optional scenes, you know. But then we get a Deathblower 3, as you saw. But if we go around here and go this way, there's a couple lights through doors. And we can go in each of these. As you'll see in a minute, Faye will be like, "Whoa, really? There's shit here?" And I'm like, yeah, there's totally shit here. As you can see, we all have haste. These enemies just move really fast. But we all have haste on every party member, so we can move super fast. So let's go ahead and beat up these guys. I don't know which one I attacked. I think it's this one. These guys aren't too powerful, honestly. So, as you can see, we're doing tons of damage with just regular attacks, so really not that powerful. And honestly, once we buy the stuff I want to get here, we're going to be a little broken. We're going to be a little broken. But yeah, I felt like I wanted to use this group, honestly, because of what's going to happen in here, as well as, like, we get Emeralda so late in the game. I know, like, I barely use Rico, and actually, I'm going to use Rico in the final battle, which is going to be a little weird. Not final boss, but, like, there's kind of a boss rush before the final battle, and I'll probably use him during that. But, anyway, we can get off our gears here. But, I don't know, like, I feel like Emeralda gets, like, nothing. Besides, like, this optional place, this isn't it, by the way, I'm just coming in here because there is some optional stuff in here. Like, in here, we get a survival tent, that's totally important. But really, what we want to see is up here. Up here, there is a little terminal we can talk to, I think it's this one. What's this movie? A record of the Zemboan culture that died out 4,000 years ago. Gee, I wonder who that is. Stop it! Who is this woman? I think that's Myong. Myong, as she appeared in the Zeboam era. But I don't know who her host body was. She resided at the side of the Prime Minister, manipulating the world behind the scenes. To resurrect Deus? In the beginning, yes, but later it was different. Many people then couldn't have children. They were defective humans. So, she did it over again. Right before man was about to be killed out by war, a new being was born to foster the next generation. Remember the missiles in the mass driver facility? That was the most important thing to the Zemboan people. Because of that, we now are descendants of the few strong people who survived. So pretty much, there was this whole thing where Myong was like, oh, well, fuck it, let's just kill everyone, I believe. And that's why, I'm just going off what I believe, but which is why we are not ones that are affected by the whole thing where people start mutating and stuff. We were never affected from that because we are descendants of people who were strong enough to survive. Or I don't know exactly. I can't just point out everything, but I'm pretty sure that's how it goes. So Ellie and I took the hopes of the people and created Emeralda. And that's it. So, sorry I didn't read that last part out, but I just wanted to show off that little scene, because yeah, it's kind of interesting. It gives you a little background information on the Zeboam era. So, there's a save point in here if you want to save. I don't really feel like I need to save, so. So now, we can get some stuff that I really want to get. So, let's go ahead and get in our gears. I kind of wish we could just go over them and press X, but that's not allowed for some reason. Alright, so up here, looks like we can get out of our gears and go in here on foot. He's going to say that every time we go near a door. So, it's kind of annoying, but whatever. So, we can go in here, and in here, there should be, like, one item, I think. I don't think there's anything more than one item. So, we'll just look around. But the next place we're going to is going to be the really important place. So in here, if I can open it, we get a Deathblower 1. These Deathblower items unlock certain Deathblows when you're in your gear form. So you realize whenever I bring my attack level up to 1, I can only do triangle, square, triangle, triangle. So, that's normal. When you have the Deathblower 1 equipped, you can do triangle X, which does a lot more damage, and it uses less fuel. So, it's really good. I might put on Deathblower 1, but also I might not, because I might need the 3 slots I have. I might need those 3 slots, honestly. I think I know I'm gonna use those 3 slots for, but I'm not 100% sure. I don't know why I jumped in my gears when I could have just ran over, but whatever. But yeah, we just need to go over here. And this is the really important place. This place right here. We're going to be getting a few things in here. I don't know why the music is so cool, but look who's here. It's Big Joe. Along with a bunch of treasure. Get a matchlock. A Rose of Sol. These items are not good at all. I believe these are random items. It can be all kinds of items, I believe, but they're all not great. But we can talk to Big Joe. How do you like my shop? Pretty good, huh? It's Joe's shop, so of course it's all Joe brand. Okay, so we can buy some really good gear parts here. Some of the shit you can get here is really crazy. So, this is what I'm getting for Fed. The Omega 100. So you get 100 output, you know, that's awesome, but the downside is you only get 1,000 fuel. It doesn't really matter, honestly, when you have a 100 output. So I'm going to be getting this for Xenogears. I was actually debating on getting this for Saiten as well, but I think I'm just going to go with Fei. So that's a thing. He sells some frames for Zabzen and Steyr for, Rico and Maria. Not really interested. We can also buy these, so you get more defense. I might buy some, but I'm not interested at the moment. So he's good to go. Faye's good to go on the engine. I wanted to get that engine because I wanted to use this. I didn't use this on my first playthrough, but I really wanted to. I just didn't have the money and I didn't feel like grinding. Because I didn't get the trader card on my first run through. But you're probably wondering why I have so much money if I was just going to get that. Well, I'm not done yet. So here is a GNR S50. This upgrades your engine output by 50%, which is ridiculous. The engine output is how much damage you do. So I'm going to buy 6 of these. Whoops. I'm going to buy 6 of these. You might think that's a little overkill, but you're right. You're right, it's overkill. I don't care, I want them. So, I'm getting those. You could buy a Z-Charger if you really wanted one. These chargers upgrade the amount of fuel you get whenever you press charge. Now, we're going to be getting one of these very soon, for free. We're going to be getting a Z-Charger. And honestly, I don't think we need any more than that one Z-Charger. So, I think we'll be okay with what we got. So, I'm not going to buy any of these. So I have some extra money now. I could get this god ammo thing, but I don't really need it. So I have some extra money now, so I'm just gonna buy armor. So we'll get one for our main team. I don't know if we'll have enough money for Saiten, but oh, we do. Okay, and that's all our money right there. I feel like that's good. I feel like that's what I want to do. So I'm going to be a little broken for a bit because of everything I just bought. But you know what? I just want to have fun. I want to have fun with this. So I'm going to kind of destroy everything, but I think it'll make it more fun. So, I mean, the final boss isn't super difficult. It's one of the hardest fights in the game. But I don't know. I think it'd be more fun this way. So No point in having frame HP because you don't have enough fuel to boost your shit. So let's just toss on this. You know what, for right now, I'm gonna give Faye two of these, which you can do, it's ridiculous. And then for the last item, I wanna give him a... I'm gonna give him the Z Charger we're gonna get, so we'll wait on that. As for everyone else, I don't really need this, so I'll go ahead and give him a GNR. And then for Emeralda, I will also give her a GNR. Now, you're probably wondering why I bought so many. I'm going to be giving these to other people in our party. And this will really help out for the final battle. So, I'm going to have some extras in my inventory for right now. I'm not going to put them on right now. I could put them on Saita and Emeralda, but I don't want to break everything. So, I think for right now, this is fine. But yeah, we're gonna be a little broken for the rest of the game. And that's what you get if you grind money in this game. You can just buy all that stuff and be the most broken piece of shit. Anyway, for the final thing in this area, and let's just show off some of this power, by the way. So, you guys. Okay, you're not a good way to show this off. 800 damage, oh shit. Wow, you guys do a ridiculous amount of damage. Okay, well, I'm gonna do the triangle attack. Let's see how much this does. Okay, 4,000. 4,000 for the triangle attack? That's pretty good. Saiten, go ahead and do a triangle. 4,700. Okay, let's try a triangle with Faye. Oh yeah, 9,000 damage. You know, whatever. Let's try an X. 9,009, that's max damage. So I'm guessing everyone can do max damage at that. Let's try a square, 9,500. And a square for Faye's probably gonna do max, yeah. We're pretty good. I mean, those guys have low defense because they're normal sized enemies. So I wouldn't base it off them, but we're pretty high leveled. I mean, we're pretty geared up, I should say. So, okay. So you're probably wondering what he's talking about, but there's a small little thing right there if you look close enough. So let's go ahead and get off our gears. If you get off here, if you look close enough, there's a little thing right there that leads into like the subway station. So if we go down here, we can just, you know, hop in here and see a bunch of little railways and stuff. But this is where the optional scene is. Alright, so also, in this little subway thing, there's an item. This item is a Z Charger, which we're going to put on Faye right away. Faye is the only one who's probably really going to need it, because he only has 1,000 fuel. So every time you charge with this, you get 500 fuel, which is half his fuel, which is great. So I feel like he'll be fine. And yeah, that's it. So now we can just keep going. So you need to bring Emeralda for this. But we're about to reach the optional scene, but you need to bring Emeralda. Do not forget Emeralda. Because it's her scene. Where are we? Congratulations, Ellie. Another year has come and passed. Yes, Happy New Year, Kim. I don't know what it is, but just now, you sounded like an old person speaking. No, well, this time last year I never thought the war would come this far. Yes. But we managed to get by without getting involved. But it's not over yet. Why, at this very moment, people are still dying. Let's stop talking about this. Let's not dwell on the past year. Not at the start of a new year. Yes, well, today at least, I want to spend a day without worrying. Stupid. Idiots. A bunch of fools. Kim, you're too loud. I don't care if they hear me. All the people here are also fools. Kim! Think about it. What's the purpose of fighting each other on such a tiny planet as this? Fighting out of fear or being hunted into a corner? Rushing in to fight as if there were only so many reserved seats to the right of life? Starting a war is stupid. Inciting it is also stupid. Killing people as an act of terrorism, or as a protest against wars that kill people is just as stupid. You're all fools! Kim, I felt sorry for that child. But I don't think people in Ravine destroyed the generator with that intention. They don't have any other ways to express themselves. The government is the one to blame. Is that a good enough reason for that child or those dead people? It wasn't much of an operation. It was difficult, but there was enough chance to win. We'd have won if we had better equipment. That child would have been saved if there was electricity. It's not just that child. 5 people died in my hospital. The ICU didn't function. Stupid. Just fools. Humans, creatures are meant to live. Why do they want to die out? Why do they strangle themselves? Humans are defective creatures. A bunch of fools. That's why genetic damage is up lately. The birth rate is also going down. Only 30 years to live? Nature, this planet, won't allow humans to live any longer than that. Am I a fool too? Huh? I had a physical at the hospital today. They said I can't have children because of hereditary genetic damage. I can't create life. I am a creature waiting to become extinct. Am I also a fool? It's no good. It's not gonna work. Somehow we must break the spell, or the humans on this planet will die out. No, I don't care about humans. Life itself will be ruined if we don't do something. Some pure life, not cursed. A pure life. This is the new spirit vessel that will break the curse. It hasn't awakened yet. The form was created by nanomachines, but neural simulation hasn't been done by the assembler tower yet. It's physically stable, but still doesn't function as a living creature yet. A nanomachine colony. No matter how many times we rewrite the heredity codes, the impressions embedded in our bodies cannot be stopped. It was necessary to pursue this further. Blech. We had to recreate the molecular... No. Actually, the atomic level, by referring to the structural patterns of you and I. This child holds our futures and possibilities. Can this child be the angel who can give us more time? I remember, long ago, you, Kim, died. Right before town died, it was because soldiers of town tried to use me. That's right. That memory, or the memory in my soul, it was left in me for your sake. While I being held, Krellian told that I, the ultimate work of art, that technology gave birth to me, or to. Yes, I knew I was thing. Look, my body. Different from Maria, Margie, and Ellie. Human imitation, but different. Kim and Ellie said I was angel. Yes. You are the child, or child I? Child I or Kim wished for. I wasn't reading the rest of the sentence. That's dumb of me. Kim has been a part of me, in my blood, passing his memory down the generations for the past 4,000 years. Existing for the day that the child, who Kim was never able to embrace for so long, would be born. Faye, thank for being substitute Kim till now. But it okay. I be strong and make Kim and Ellie proud that I their child. What? Faye, body so hot. Faye, hold me tight. This is a little creepy. Don't let go.
Okay. A little creepy.
And Emeralda grows. Faye, body. I became adult. I not get in your way anymore.
And just like that, that's the cutscene. I don't fucking know why that's optional, because I'll just say this, during the ending, there's a, you know, there's a FMV, like a video. And it shows Emeralda grown up. She's not a kid in that cutscene. So this is canon. This you're pretty much supposed to go do this, but it's optional. Why? Why is this optional? I don't understand, honestly. I don't understand why this is optional. But now that Emeralda has grown up, she's older now. So there you go. That's the scene. Sorry I was flubbing up the lines as usual. It's just something that happens. But yes, that's all we came down here for, honestly. It's really hidden. It's hidden really well, too. Like, back when this came out, there was no internet and no bullshit like that. There was a player's guide. So if you had the player's guide, you could obviously find it. But how the fuck are you supposed to find this when, like... like when you're just playing on your own, and when you see the final cutscene and like see her all grown up, you're like, what the fuck? Like, why is she like that? What's going on? So it's just weird. Like, I don't understand their thinking when they did that. It's really weird. If you have some kind of explanation for why they made this kind of scene optional, let me know, but for now, I am still astounded on why that is optional. Also, considering that Emeralda barely got anything in this game. She barely got shit out of story. I mean, obviously she got like a few things, but it's very negligible compared to everyone else. Oh my god, I was trying to run away and I can't run away. It's very, very small compared to everyone else. So, if you don't do that, you're getting nothing out of Emeralda. Which is sad. Because she is an important character. She is basically Feyenelli's daughter. God damn, are you kidding me? Okay. No, these guys are gonna be super fast. I know I probably should cut this out, but just keep this in for right now. Okay, can I run away, please? Can I run away, please? Thank you. But yeah, that's everything. Now all we have left is the final dungeon. But yeah, it's like, I don't know, I'm still confused, honestly, with their design decision behind that. Because it doesn't make sense. It literally doesn't make sense why they chose to hide that. To not make it, like, to make it optional. I don't get it. It's weird. I know I've been saying that for the past 10 minutes, but that's how I feel. It's really weird. Okay, so now we're ready to head to Deus. Before we get going, though, I want to go ahead and charge up my gears, tune them up a little bit. So, give me a second. I don't think it does it automatically. Oh, it does. They're full now. That's weird. Okay, well, let's get going, then. I'm gonna go ahead and save, actually, now that we have Emeralda all grown up. She hit puberty pretty quickly. It's a little awkward, that scene at the end, where it's like, please hold me tight, and I'm like, wait, you're my daughter, I don't wanna think this way. Just gonna take a little drink there. But we're done here, so let's get going. Let's launch the Udrasil and get going. But yeah, so that's everything I wanted to do in the lighthouse. Got some items from Big Joe. A thing about Big Joe that's only in the Perfect Works, I believe, is he's from the Zeboam era. He's 4,000 years old. he's actually a pretty big character. It's really weird. I'm surprised they don't go into a lot more detail about it. Or maybe they do and I just miss it, but if you read The Perfect Works, he's a really old character. Like, he's from the era from 4,000 years ago, and there's a bunch of our backstory stuff. It's really weird. So anyway, final dungeon time. Welcome to Deus. The God. Pretty much.